welcome to episode 2 of the show. I think I've pulled everything out of the bag. We should cut it. Welcome to episode 2 of the show. I think I've done it all this time. I pulled everything out of my ass this time. Ha, that's not very funny. Podcast, brand new. This is a brand new episode. Episode 2. This time, we're pulling out all the stumps. Shut up, Adam. This is good stuff. This is what TV is supposed to be. This is goofy TV for a goofy TV station and goofy people out there. I hope you guys like this. This is cut it.
I was just laughing. Okay.
Right. I really. Here, let's play it. Just start recording me. Here. Start filming me. Love you guys. Okay. All right. Episode 2, it's done, and it's ready for air. I hope you guys like this. You can check me out online. Email me at theshowsucks@AOL.com. I need feedback. Actually, the first 50 people that email me, because I haven't gotten any emails at all, and I put this on episode 1, and I was expecting somebody to email me. Nobody freaking emailed me. I guess I'm a loser, but whatever. Yeah, the first 50 people that email me this, you know, just saying whatever, I'll give them a button, and a sticker, too.
Free button and stickers. Free. Whoa, that's awesome!
Free buttons and stickers, and it's exciting, as you can see. Something to get excited about. These guys are loving it. And you should too, so freaking get a hold of me, all right? I'm also on myspace.com. I'll scroll this through. Get on there, check me out, you know. The whole cast is on there, the whole cast and crew. So, I hope you guys enjoy the show, episode number 2. Look forward to episode number 3 sometime, I don't know when, probably in a month or so. But, yeah, check it out later.
Great galaxy, what are those weird things? Uh-oh, a sneak attack.
Yeah, we got the Binks this time, that doucher McPherson.
Yeah, big doucher.
We sent him away.
Sent him away?
We sent him to the downtown.
Yeah, that's where we sent him.
He's gone.
He's not here anymore.
He's not here anymore.
No.
Turn it off. Man, this is boring. What are we gonna do?
We could go to Perkins.
Nah, I've kind of been there a million times, guys. Yeah, I don't have any money. Nah.
How about Walmart? I like Walmart.
Walmart, I don't want
to
buy anything.
Down there for trying on girls' clothes.
I think we've all, yeah.
What are you talking about?
I don't want to walk around.
No,
no.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Another loser.
Just try again.
Bored now.
Bored.
Bored.
We're all bored now.
Boring.
Fine.
We could call that one weird kid. What's his name? Like Master Snorlax or something?
Snorlax? I don't know,
oh,
man.
The mayor of Toronto.
That's Snorlax, kid.
He's a
weirdo. He's a weirdo.
I need new friends. Wanna be my friend, Mr. Moose?
The notorious Snar Snar Binks. Oh, Snarl.
McBinks lives.
I hate this. I wish I had friends. I'll be your Woody Buzz. Dumbass.
Man, I hope this kid answers. You know, he doesn't have any life. He's probably at home playing G.I. Joes.
Yeah, I hope so too. I want to.
Yeah, he likes playing with action.
No, there's nothing else to do.
I don't even know
town.
If I like him.
It's better than Walmart.
We're pretty desperate, Colin.
Hey,
yeah.
I like Walmart.
Huh? Who the hell could be calling me? Hello?
Yes, is this the mayor of East Romberg?
Oh, this is Snarls McBanks!
What you doing, Snar Snar? You wanna come over and hang out with hot chicks and be our friend?
Yeah!
Yeah.
Man, this kid's really douchey.
This kid is a pretty big douche, if I've ever seen one. What do you guys think?
He's definitely a bag of a douche.
Definitely a douche bagger. He bags douches for fun.
Ah, Binks!
Snar!
Hey! Grab him! Chris, grab him! Who's Binks now? Who's King Binks now? This one's for all the people back at home. You're going down, Binks! You're going down! Going downtown!
Yeah! Snar!
Come on!
Get him, girls! Get him while he's down! Kick the snarl! You're going down, McBanks. You're going down. Nothing. Nothing without your pretty hair. You're going down, McBanks. You're nothing without this.
Your
pretty hair and your pretty head and all this. You're going down. McBanks is no more. You're dead, man. You're dead of the world. Yay! Andrew has friends now.
Yeah.
That's kablamo.
Every now and then I get a little bit nervous that the best of all the years have gone by. Every now and then I feel a little bit terrified, but then I see the look in your eye. Every now and then I fall apart. Every now and then I fall apart. And I need you more tonight. And I need you more than ever. And if you'd only hold me tight, we'll be holding on forever. And we'll always be making it right, 'cause we'll never be wrong. Together we can take it to the end of the line. My love is like a shadow on you all the time. I don't know what to do, and I'm always in the dark. I'm running with cattle break and giving up sparks. I really love you tonight. Forever's gonna start tonight. Forever's gonna start to. Once upon a time I was falling in love, but now I'm only falling apart. Nothing I can say, a total eclipse of the heart. Once upon a time there was light in my life, but now there's only love in the dark. Nothing I can do, a total eclipse of the heart. I was falling in love, but now I'm only falling apart. Nothing I can say, your total eclipse of the heart.
This next video is about my friend who was a grocery bagger down at Eagles. I worked with him. He's pretty hardcore.
This guy's a loser.
He's the greatest grocery bagger ever. he'll come after you guys.
Whatever.
He has no shame.
I'll come after you guys.
Yeah, right. He's the greatest. He's Wayne Gilbert, bitch.
That guy sucks.
You can't fuck with Wayne Gilbert. Oh. Ain't that right?
I'll mess him up.
Javier!
Yeah.
My name's Wayne, and I love my job. I'm a grocery bagger at downtown Eagle Country Market. I rock.
So, how long have you worked here?
Oh, about 2 years. 2.5 years, you know, since March of my sophomore year.
So awesome. What do you think of Wayne?
Wayne? Wow. He's a real man. Wow. He's got tattoos. That's hot.
I'm Wayne Gilbert.
So how long have you been working at Eagles?
Oh, you know, probably about a year or so. I used to work here before, you know, but probably about a year now.
Sweet. What do you think of Wayne?
Wayne? Wayne's pretty hardcore. He's a renegade. There was this one time when this guy was shoplifting and he just kind of chased him down and did some weird wrestling body slam like move. It was insane.
Hey, I think that guy's shoplifting. Get him! Somebody get him! Oh! Call the cops!
So Brett, how long have you worked here?
I've worked at Eagles for about 3 or 4 months.
Okay, cool. What do you think about Wayne?
Wayne, he's an alright guy. He helped protect me from his bully who's trying to steal my lunch money once in school. So, he's pretty good.
Give me all your lunch money!
Oh, screw you.
Hey, get out of here!
Give me all your lunch money.
That was so gay.
I'm serious. Give me all your money.
Oh, man.
That's right. Wayne Gilbert.
Sometimes I like to help customers every once in a while.
Hey. Hey, you over there.
Huh? Me?
Yeah, you. I want to help you. I want to give you...
Huh?
A helping?
Help me with what?
Hand.
Uh-huh.
A job well done.
Wayne? Yeah, he's a recluse. Sometimes I just don't know about that kid. Oh, I got new messages. Let's check them out and see what people have to say.
You have 7 old messages.
7 messages.
Monday, 6:52 p.m.
Baby, it's Kristen. I'm giving you a call like you wanted me to. Call me back. Bye.
Hi, Kristen. Love you.
Monday, 7:11 p.m.
Stevie, it's Colton, dude. Answer the phone. I know you're there. Fucking smell, you stupid cunt. Motherfucker, you bailed out on me yesterday. I'm gonna come over there and bring your house down. Love you.
I love you too, Colton.
Hi, friend. You should give me a call. This is Brian. Hi.
My friends are goofy.
Monday, 7:37 p.m. Monday, 11:02 p.m.
Hey, Stevie, there's 4 of us here, and we're going to go to Snowless's, so you should show up with your camera. fucking cunt. I hate you.
Tuesday, 7:20, 7 p.m. Tuesday, 9:00 p.m.
Hey, Stevie, what's up? This is Colton. I wanted to talk to you about something. Something that's going down this evening. Pretty much like as we speak, and I am super open and invited to this really cool thing that's going on. And I thought, dude, I'd include you. Just get a hold of me in my basement line, upstairs line, whatever. Just get a hold of me as soon as you can. Try to see if we make this thing rocking, because instead of going on, I want to get a part of it really soon, and it involves multiple females, et cetera, et cetera. So give me a call back as soon as you can, see. In case you didn't know, this is Oxy Colton. Because I'm going to fucking money. Peace.
Fucking Colton.
Wednesday, 1:06 a.m.
Hey, big guy, this is Sarah. I was calling to say that last night was great. You should call me back real soon so we can do that again, Hottie. Later, Stevie.
Something's wrong. Less talk and more action. Now it's your turn.
We're here at the show. I almost kind of blew up my house. I really almost did. I broke a gas line. And this is getting pretty crazy. Kind of accidentally almost blew up my house. I busted a gas line. This is kind of, it's neat, but it's not neat at all. Colton, I'm sorry I couldn't make it to the mall on time. I hope you understand. But I have all these fire trucks and I have to deal with these people. Check it. Yeah. This is pretty freaking renegade right here. I hope you guys enjoy this, because I don't know if I do. I gotta hang out and wait for gasline people, plus my dad to come home, and that's not gonna be cool at all. Hope you like the show.
True story of what happened to me over Christmas vacation. What you need to be warned that this video, it contains explicit content with gnomes. Explicit.
Christmas vacation had begun, a time for lots of joy and fun. Joy and fun for everyone that is, except for one.
I hate Christmas vacation. I hate it a lot. Most people enjoy it, but me, I do not. I hate the cold. I hate the snow. I hate those Christmas specials they always fucking show. There's no Christmas magic. I don't believe in such things. The only elves that I like are from Lord of the Rings. I'm so bored and lonely. How can I be merry? I have nothing to do till at least January. I wish that I could get away from here to a place that is far, not a place that is near. A place filled with magic, a place that won't suck. If I leave now, I'll get there with a little bit of luck. Adam failed to notice, as he talked to himself, that something had snuck in and stood on his shelf.
Excuse me, sir, but I happen to hear you wish to go somewhere far and not near.
Who are you? Why'd you break into my home?
My name is Rusty. I'm a magical gnome.
I want out of this place. It's really a drag. I'm ready to leave. I'll pack up my bag.
You want to escape? You want to flee? Well, I've got the ticket, but it won't come for free.
Well, I am a little short on money. I hope you aren't thinking about anything funny.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime chance. Don't be so modest. Just take off your pants.
All right. If that's the only way. Nobody's watching, so I guess it's okay. So Adam disrobed, and the gnome had his fun. After an hour, the deed had been done. Now, like you promised, it's time to go.
Yeah, about that, there's something you should know. I was listening to you talking while I was hiding behind the glass, so I thought of a plan to fuck you in the ass. Sorry for everything. I didn't mean to be rude, but I'm not a gnome. I'm just a midget, dude.
This is a film by Fuckface Digitalis the 17th, also known as Tim Potoff. This is a film by Fuckface Digitalis the 17th, otherwise known as Tim Potoff.
We should locate our IT resources wisely.
How can you have devil's hesitate to change your life?
I don't have time for this.
Plays or skits.
Hello, my baby.
Severe schizophrenia is trying to get you down. Talk to your doctor about anti-skits. Anti-skits has been proven to suppress the effects of schizophrenia for up to 18 hours with just one pill.
Hey, what are you doing with that pill? Go!
What do you think, Window? I think we should pull together all of our independent IT resources.
Anti-skits. Kiss the devil up fast.
Anti-skits may cause dehydration, nasal drainage, abdominal leak, extra sleep, and all the things that ask your doctor before administering anti-skit suppositories to children under 12.
Hi! Stop shaking the camera. Okay, we gotta steady this. I hope you guys liked episode 2 of the show. I think it turned out pretty good. We spent a lot of time rendering it and putting transitions in, all that goofy stuff. But yeah, I hope you guys liked it. Send me feedback. The show sucks at AOL.com. I'll scroll that. I've scrolled before. I'll do it again. I'm also going to write free buttons, too, if anybody wants any. But either way, I hope you guys enjoyed the show. If anybody wants to be in a skit or is interested in putting stuff on or in the show, let me know. Get a hold of me. You know my email address. You should by now. I've told you a million different times. But yeah, episode 2 turned out good. I'm happy with it. Stop laughing. You guys have fun. I'll see you in the future. Take care. Yeah. Bye.
Love you. See you later. Check out the credits. Later.
When I was just a little girl, I ask my mother, what will I be? Will I be pretty? Will I be rich? Here's what she said to me. Que sera, sera. Whatever will be. The future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera. What will be. When I grew up and fell in love, I asked my sweetheart, what lies ahead? Will we have rainbows day after day? Here's what my sweetheart said. Que sera, sera. Whatever will be. The future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera. What will be. Now I have children of my own. They ask their mother, what will I be? Will I be handsome? Will I be rich? I tell them tenderly. Hey, said I, said I, whatever will be, will be. The future's not ours to see. Hey, said I, what will be, will be. Hey, said I, said I.
Oh, fuck, it's recording. What the fuck's it recording for?